So let's talk about what he said and what President Obama said earlier about addressing these root causes of terrorism. Let's bring in terrorism experts Fran Townsend, a former Bush administration Homeland Security and Counterterrorism Advisor, and David Gartenstein-Ross, a senior fellow at the Foundation for the Defense of Democracies. Fran, let's start with you. Very interesting to hear the British Prime Minister say that a lot of these lone wolf terrorists, or otherwise, whatever they are, whatever kind of terrorists they are initially initiated into extremist Islam, not by preachers who preach violence, but by preachers who preach hatred without violence. That seems like a very big problem for Western powers to try to combat. How do you do that?
It's very difficult, Jake, but what he said was very important, and that is, it's not just that we're combating violent extremism. We have to commit ourselves to combating extremism in all its forms. Look, it is a challenge, and I think that's why it's very important to have public-private partnerships. You know, this week, Ambassador Mark Wallace, formerly with the UN during the Bush administration, and I announced the Counter-Extremism Project. The idea is to provide that counter-narrative, to create a public-private partnership where the private sector and non-governmental organizations can actually help. You know, in the UK, there's an organization of young British Muslims, Not In My Name. There's the project for the promotion of peace in Muslim societies, led by a sheikh, a Muslim sheikh. You need all of these groups and these voices to come together and work collaboratively with the government effort, because governments can't do it alone. It is very difficult for governments to attack this problem.
And David, let me ask you, because I saw criticism online of one of the individuals, it may have in fact been the sheikh that Fran was just talking about, for having belonged to an organization of Islamic scholars that years ago supported a fatwa allowing Muslims to fight against the Americans in Iraq. At one point this year, the State Department Counterterrorism Division tweeted a link to this sheikh's website. And then after it was criticized because of positions the sheikh had taken, they deleted the tweet and said they shouldn't have tweeted it. It's not always easy finding pure individuals to represent this cause of moderation, I suppose.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. And it's difficult to both, number one, make sure that the people who are representing a moderate cause have a good track record, but number two, conversely, make sure that they have credibility with the audience that you're trying to reach. This creates a dilemma, which is, what exactly is the audience? Is it young people who are at risk of succumbing to extremist ideology? If so, someone who has a perfect track record as a moderate might be seen as not really speaking to their particular worldview. But conversely, as you pointed out, when people are too edgy or perhaps aren't really moderate at all, that obviously presents its own dilemma.
Fran, Americans have felt like targets for terrorists for a long time, but of course we've seen in the past few weeks British citizens, a horrific video today of a French citizen. Are our eyes opening in this country that other Westerners are just as much victims of this kind of terrorism? Or indeed, are they becoming more and more targets along with Americans?
Oh, I think for sure what you're seeing is that ISIS and groups like it are expanding their target set. What they're trying to do, you know, this is an incredibly virulent form of political Islam, right? What they're trying to do is they're using these beheadings in an attempt to influence the foreign policies of not only the United States, but our Western allies. They're going to fail at this for the most part. I'm not sure. I think we've got to understand why a country like Turkey isn't doing more, isn't more active, an active partner in the alliance, because if ISIS and groups like it get the sense that they can really intimidate and influence government policies, they'll do more of this, and that's dangerous for everybody. The president's effort at the UN this week is very important, but it will be more important than the speech is going to be outcomes. This time next year, will those same countries who voted unanimously this afternoon on the resolution be willing to stand up and say, what have they actually done and what have they actually accomplished?
David, I just want to get your view on this Algerian terrorist sect, Yund Al Khalifa, translated loosely as Soldiers of the Caliphate. They beheaded a French hostage today. The leader of this sect pledges allegiance to the leader of ISIS. They are not officially a part of ISIS. What else do we know about this group?
Jinnah Khalifa had been around for a while. It originally was known as the Al-Qaeda in the Islamic Maghreb Center Zone. And actually, their pledge of allegiance to ISIS isn't new. They had pledged allegiance several months ago. It's just that they now took on this new name, Jinnah Khalifa, and also announced the pledge of allegiance to Baghdadi again. One thing that should be said is that they're pretty established. They actually, in the Algerian Civil War, they'd been part of the Armed Islamic Group, or the GIA, whereas Al-Qaeda supported the GSPC, which was their competitor in Algeria. The reason I mention that is because the GIA was the more hard line of the two groups, and this relates to how groups are breaking, which is that groups that tend to be a bit more hardline and a bit more prone to indiscriminate as opposed to strategic uses of violence tend towards ISIS rather than to Al-Qaeda. The thing that should be reassuring is the fact that this isn't a fly-by-night operation. They've been around for a while, and even though the beheading is absolutely gruesome, it's also not very strategic because, frankly, the French probably would have paid them a lot of money to let him go, number one. And number two, this means they're going to be at the very top of the Algerian counterterrorism radar.
That's right. The French derided by U.S. officials for paying those ransoms. Fran Townsend, David Gartenstein-Ross, thank you so much. Stay with us if you would.